a sec. Mr. Mulvaney told Lisa she could use the cabin anytime she wants to. He has a spare key under the kitchen window beneath the rock.
Okay, hopefully that's where she's got Robin.
If she took Robin in the hall.
Hey, I'm sorry. I know that you're the boss, but since Patrick spent the night in lockup, I mean, is it really necessary to keep him at work right away? I mean, I want you to leave with me right now.
I appreciate you worrying about me, but I'm okay.
I disagree. You need to rest.
It's not gonna happen. Honestly, I'm a little bit wired from being locked up, and I think getting back to work is probably the best thing for me right now.
You just said it. You're wired, right? Not just from last night. Try the months of dealing with Robin's endless drama. I am not going to take no for an answer. We're going to go grab lunch, we'll rent a DVD, and we'll chill.
I'm afraid that's not going to work.
Why not?
Because I can't spare you. A patient is coming up from ER. Sounds like a femur to pelvis rebuild, and I want you to take it. OR5 is being prepped as we speak.
All right. Well, you know what? Since you're so determined to work, how about you scrub in? Hey. Actually, this is a better idea, because you've always said that you're never more centered than when you're in the OR. So assist me. All right, we can kill two birds with
one stone. I'm afraid I'm going to have to pull rank on this one, too. If you're going to stick around, I want you on that head trauma we've been consulting about.
Okay.
Put this over. If you still feel like you need assistance, I'll get Dr. Novak.
All right, well, normally if I don't have Patrick, I would just do the surgery myself, but this could be a complicated rebuild.
Epiphany, could you please page Dr. Novak?
Right away, doctor.
Okay, I am really worried about you, and I don't think that you should be alone, so please meet me after we scrub out.
Okay, I can do that.
Promise?
Yes. She knows.
Knows what?
I think she's figured it out. She's trying to turn it on me.
Or maybe she just wanted you to scrub in for a surgery.
She's trying to keep me at the hospital instead of looking for Robin. She knows that I'm on to her.
Well, I hope you're right. Because from what I've seen, you're just grasping at straws.
Keep her at the hospital as long as you can, okay? Do that?
Yeah, I'll take care of it. Good luck.
Hey, how much longer is Patrick supposed to be in surgery?
He's not. He's already signed out.
And left?
That's usually what your doctors do when you sign out. And do not ask me where Drake Jr. went, because it is not my week to keep him.
Did Steve take the head trauma case?
Dr. Weber's in a meeting. Is something wrong, Dr. Niles?
No, I'm fine, thanks.
Dr. Renfro, call 6474. Dr. Mabel Renfro, call 6474.
Hi, may I speak with Donald Mulvaney? It's Dr. Lisa Niles. Hi, Don. It's Dr. Lisa Niles. Yeah, quick question. Did someone from General Hospital call you recently? Yeah, and you told them about the cabin? No. There's no problem. There was some wires that were crossed. Okay. Thank you. Bye. You know what? I need to leave, so sign me out.
Wait, aren't you supposed to be doing surgery with Dr. Novak?
He'll be fine. I just need to save a friend from ruining his life.
Robin! Robin! You in here? Robin! Robin! Robin? You out here? Robin, if you can hear me, say something! Patrick, you here? Answer me. Robin, can you hear me?
Patrick. Patrick?
Robin!
Patrick! I'm down here!
Robin!
Patrick!
Any update on Lisa's surgery? As in, is it running long, short?
Don't you doctors ever talk to each other? The surgery is estimated for another 3 hours, but Dr. Niles signed out already. Dr. Novak is doing the surgery.
Did Dr. Niles say where she was going?
Look, is something going on around here? Because Dr. Niles was acting strange, too.
How so?
She asked me if Drake had already signed out, and I told her that he was gone, and she got all tense and made a call to someone named Mulvaney.
Is there anything else you can tell me?
She hung up, and then she said something about saving a friend from ruining his life.
Great. Thank you. Steve, Lisa knows you know about the cabin. She's on her way there.
All right. Well, I need to sit down just for a second.
Easy. Okay? Here, take some water. How long were you down there for?
I don't know. Forever. Where's Emma?
She's okay. The police found her sitting in her car seat after Lisa took you.
Is that what happened?
You don't remember?
No, I was at Uncle Mac's, and then, I was in some cabin, and Lisa was standing over me.
She must have drugged you. Okay, well, let me get a look at you. Make sure you're all right.
No, I'm fine. Nothing's broken. It's just fell a couple times, actually. It's a miracle.
Well, we were due for one. Robin, did Lisa throw you down the well?
No. I guess whatever drug she gave me really dizzy, and I couldn't stand, so I sat there and I listened to her. I listened to her rationalize and justify her obsession with you, which was beyond creepy. I just waited it out. I waited until I could regain my strength, and I pushed her aside and I ran out. But, you know, it was dark. I couldn't see anything, and my legs were weak, and I guess I just fell. I trapped myself.
This isn't your fault. This is Lisa's doing. I'm just glad you're okay. I'm so sorry. I promise you, I'm never gonna let her hurt you again. I'm so sorry.
You have more?
I'm sure there's more in the cabin, but I don't want you to drink too much. Your body's been taxed.
Okay. Can we get out of here now?
Call the police. Get you to the hospital. Easy.
I can't let you do that.
Lisa, listen to me.
Shut up, you bastard, okay? You did this to me. All right, you said that you love me. You said that we had another chance, but you know what? You're just a coward, Patrick. Okay, because you can't face the truth about yourself that you married an ice-cold, controlling bitch and you're miserable. God, this is not my fault.